For this,
I
request chair and co-chair persons, Dr. D.N. Saraf and Dr. S.M. Nandi, please take seats at the dais. Thank you. And speakers for this session are Dr. Vishwanathan. His will be the first presentation, followed by Babita Behra, then Mr. Ravi Chandran. Of course, the details are there with the chair and co-chair. They'll be inviting the speakers. I am just telling who are the people who will be speaking in this session. Then Swamin Das Gupta,
is there much influence of surface hydroxyl group in Fischer crops? And the, is there much influence of surface hydroxyl group?
Better hand over to Chair Ingo Chair.
As far as I know, no one's ever been able to find that.
So that's also around 300, so it should be.
Yes.
There should be quite a lot of hydroxyl groups for
it's got to. Well, if the mechanism oxygenate, at some point you got to let the oxygen go as hydroxide.
You have a carbon monoxide.
Welcome to the first session.
On the
Hello. With the iron, it's the carbide.
Hello.
And infrared. We're going to try to do the cobalt.
We are already running a little late.
With the infrared.
Therefore, we have to keep the time very strictly. We have six speakers. And the time allotted for each speaker to make a presentation is 10 minutes.
Hello.
But the hydrocarbon will make it hard to do.
We have six papers.
The
time allotted for each person would be 10 minutes for presentation and 2 minutes for discussion. And we will have to strictly adhere to this time schedule. So please try and make your presentation within 10 minutes. And after, at 9 minutes, I'll give a one ring. And after 10 minutes, two rings. And at that point, you must stop. I hope you'll pardon me for being really strict on this, but these are instructions from the organizers and I'll have to follow them.
With
this, I invite the first speaker from BPCL, Kochi, Dr. Vishwanathan, Shri Prasad and Sasi are the three co-authors. Sasi will make the presentation. The title is Study of Effect of ZSM Additives in FCC Catalyst, Product Quality and Refinery Economics. Mr. Sasi, please.
SM Nandi and my dear
delegates. See, we have a small presentation about the
ZSM by additive.
See, we have a small presentation of the study we had conducted in Kochi refinery on the effect of ZSM by additives in the FCC catalyst process. ZSM by additives, as you know, has been widely used for increasing of LPG olefins in various refineries. And we have an R&D setup where we evaluate all the ZSM by additives we get from all the vendors. We have done the evaluation and selected some vendor for the additive supply. Then we have conducted another study for the optimal quantity of ZSM by to be added in the FCC catalyst. So now we first will, I'll just go through the FCC technology fast, then I'll go to ZSM by additive. And we will see the working of ZSM by additive. And then we will come to the trial at the BPCL Kochi refinery. So as I said, we had an evaluation process, which I will not be telling in detail here. Then the second part, which is ascertaining the optimum addition rate, will be will discuss it slightly detailed. And finally, we will come to the effects on refinery economics. This is known to everybody, I will not explain. This is the normal FCC process. In Kochi refinery, we have one additional thing, that is, we have an air enrichment with oxygen. Since we had a high limitation in the regenerator with superficial velocities, we had gone for an air enrichment in the oxygen, which increases the oxygen content to something like 25.4%. Then, this is another overview about the FCC in BPCL. The capacity is 1.75 around TPA. Then, design case feed is 218 tons. Then, that is the VGO combustion. Processing objective is maximization of LPG, fins, and gasoline. Then, post revamp, we are planning for a strain gauge of 36 months, maybe 2 turnarounds. And we have changed the regenerator operation to complete combustion. This is another specifications about our FCCU. After the revamp, we have made the feed injection nozzles from Stroh and Webster. We have a cold wall Y and riser section. Then the additional Y stabilization steam ring has come. In reactor, we have gone for high efficiency single stage cyclones. And new riser termination device has come, which is the LD spiral. Then we have introduced structure packing in the reactor for effective stripping. Then there is a CLO backwash provision in the feed injectors, which is for future use. And in addition to that, we have gone for oxygen enrichment, as I said earlier. This is the design conditions. Next. This is the operating conditions of the unit design. Feed is 280 tons, riser outlet temperature is 534, region is 691, cathode ratio of 6.47, then cathode circulation 23.5 tons, MABIR is 108, which was limiting, and then we have gone for this oxygen. Oxygen rate of 3.67, then O2 percentage will come up to 25.25. Then catalyst, normal batch is ECAT is 69. This is again regarding the SSC catalyst, it contains the CRI and matrix. This is known to everybody. Then the CRI is active component, it contains the active acid sites. This aids in the cracking the edges of small molecules. The CRI is incorporated in the matrix, which aids in cracking up molecules too large to readily enter the pore structure of CRI. Matrix imparts good adhesion resistance to the catalyst. Now we'll come to the system by IDG. Of late, we know that our intention was to go for more of LPG and high gasoline octane. And we have limitations, tetraether lattice banned years before. Then there is then the next option was to improve the FCC by changing operating conditions. And hardware is very difficult, we cannot afford to change it often. Then there is a need for alternate means of improving octane. So the suggestion was to change the catalyst and or the additive used. We use a catalyst containing optimum unit cell size of ultra-stable Y-cycle USY or RUSY. Then another option was to use Cetazepi additive, either as a separate additive along with the present catalyst or as a composite along with it. This gives a structure of the normal processor catalyst and the Cetazepi particles. As you see here, you can see that the cage opening is less for this cetazepi pipe, which enables the smaller molecules to only enter the cetazepi pipe and get cracked. Again, about the additive, it's a shape selective CLI with irregular pore openings of 5 to 5.6 angstroms. It's used commercially since 1970s. It has been found to increase the gasoline octane number by 3 to 4 numbers. Cetazepi additives are used to increase the yields of C4 olefins, apart from increasing octane. At PPCL, the prime intention of using the additive was to increase LPG enhancement, because we don't have any recovery system for the petrochemical feedstocks. Then the reaction is, it's a 10-membered sieve containing channel openings of 5.1 to 5.6. It reacts in molecules more than 6 angstroms is severely limited because of the low pore size. Access of molecules more than monomethyl aliphatics is restricted to cetazepi. It has a strong bronchial size for cracking hydrocarbons. Does not catalyze the bulk formation, which is an undesirable particle, as in YCLI. It increases the C4 LPG selectivity with a concurrent decrease in the gasoline selectivity. The olefins and aromatics increase and paraffins has come down on percentage. There is essentially no change in the dry gas or the COX selectivity. The combustion change in the gasoline. Coming to gasoline, you can see that C7 plus painting and branch olefins and paraffins will decrease. Rate of olefin cracking is more than the paraffin cracking. C7 plus gets cracked into give mainly C3 and C5 olefins. And the olefin cracking produces log chain paraffins in the gasoline. C5 hydrocarbons are found to increase, and the density of the gasoline will come down. Concentration of aromatics and naphthenes increases. That is the relative. When the percentage volume of gasoline comes down, it increases. Then the balance between increase in octane number, C3, C4 olefin yields, and decrease in the gasoline yield will depend on factors such as quality of VGO, then operating conditions, and type of the catalyst used. This is a methodology study we adopted in Kochi refineries. We had fresh shell base catalyst was steam deactivated using 100% steam at 780 degrees for 5 hours. This deactivation protocol was selected by us. The status of additives were also deactivated at the same conditions. Then we have a circulating riser pilot plant. Pilot plant studies were conducted with base catalyst and with varying concentration of ceres and pipes in the catalyst base. Then the feed use was representative of the feed use in the FCC plant itself. That particular VGO mix of 50% pH and 50% PG was selected. Operating conditions of the pilot plant was reactor is maintained at 580 degrees centigrade, regenerator is 665, and that oil ratio of 5 to 8. The gaseous product was analyzed in a RGI, and the liquid products were distilled in a TPP apparatus, and the cuts obtained were further characterized. This slide gives the product gas analysis. As you see, the dry gas, there is no much variation in the combustion depending on the increase in cesium pipe. Hydrogen, ethane, ethylene all remained almost the same. Methane has slightly come down. This is a graphical representation of the same data. You can see that methane has come down, the other things are almost steady. Then coming to the LPG section, there is, as you see the bottom line, you can see there is a marked increase in the LPG production. It has gone up from 13.02 to 21.54. Depending on the increase in additive, there is a marked increase in the LPG. And individual components also, if you see, there is an increase in all the individual components. And maximum increase is for, next slide, maximum increase you can see for propylene and isobutene. This is a distinctive pattern. As you see, as I have mentioned earlier, most of the LPG make comes from the gasoline reduction. C5-160 has come down from 36.68 to 30.71, and the conversion is almost steady. This is a graphical of one. You can see that gasoline has come down, while the heavy naphtha has come down a little, and LCO, it has no marked reduction is there. This slide shows the octane numbers. You can see the gasoline octane has gone up from 89 to 93.9. And the heavy naphtha octane has gone up from 83.3 to 87.3. And this is the main factor which contributes to the economics of the refinery. Next. This is a product yield pattern, again, which I have shown in the other way also. You can see that LPG has gone on increasing and gasoline has strategically come down. These are the observations which we made. There is an increase in LPG yield. Octane value is also increased with increased addition of ceresium pipe. Then, even though there is a reduction in gasoline, maybe after fraction, quality of the product is enhanced by increase in raw and mod. Then, I have told, major portion of the LPG increase is obtained from gasoline and slightly from heavy naphtha. I will come to the economics. There is a limitation of time. See the coming to the economic point of view, we can see that the yield pattern before modification, this is the basis for economic calculations. I just flip through this because this is the standard condition which I have assumed. Because our unit operates normally at 190 tons per hour, this is the standard conditions assumed. And this one, you can see the cost, this is the average cost of throughout a year from July 2005 to July 2006. And the important thing is that LPG is priced significantly lower than gasoline. It's around 22,900 rupees, whereas the gasoline is 29,600. And that is why when the LPG is going up, the refinery stands to lose. Then these are the observations. It is observed that there is a shift in the product pattern depending on percentage of additive. the increase in octane barrels contribute to the refinery economics. Then the loss in yield of gasoline gets offset by the higher blending capacity obtained by the increase in octane number of gasoline as well as heavy number. Then as you everybody knows, the pricing mechanism has an adverse effect on the refinery economics. LPG will price significantly low.
Finished.
The last one. The conclusions. The technology of SMI is widely known and accepted. It's imperative for each unit to study in detail the feed characteristics, catalyst, additives, and arrive at a best viable SMI addition rate. Because we cannot say that this is the best rate because it all depends on price and all those things. Continuous evaluation and optimization of the additive consideration depending on dynamics of product pricing, feed composition, and operating conditions are absolutely essential for the overall economics of the refinery. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kachin. I think we'll just allow one question. Anybody has one question? Okay, thank you.
As of now, we are not giving. We have a question in the detector, but we are not giving.
That might have eroded your engine. And you have converted regenerator to this concrete combustion.
Yeah.
Did you put some petrol or
what?
Did you provide some?
You are asking whether they put some CO promoter?
No, not CO promoter.
For complete combustion, regeneration would be autonomous. How are you taking away that rate? So, did you give some provision of petrol?
No, no. We have not given a petrol. The instant has gone up to something like 710 degrees only. From the previous level, we are not doing a calculator. We have a CO boiler for the heat recovery. Okay. That is really on operation.
So you could manage it.
No, no, it does not increase much on the dry gas. It is giving an increase in the LPG. Dry gas has not increased.
No, no, what I have told is based on the catalyst. 2% based on the catalyst.
I think this is not benefiting the rest of the audience, so please do it after the session.
Okay.
Let's give a hand to Mr. Sachin. I invite the next speaker. The next speaker is from IIT Dehradun, Babita Behra, Alokwani, and Siddharth Ray. Siddharth Ray will make the presentation. The title is Understanding the Structure of SCC Catalyst and Associated Coke from Fresh and Regeneration Stages in a FCC Refining Unit, the Multi Nuclear Solid State NMR Approach. Mr. Siddharth Ray, please.
Hello. Good morning, Chairman and Co-Chairman and everybody. So directly I'll go to this topic because since the time constant